I'm just doing a quick video for people to look at the chemtrails in Halifax today. And for anyone who thinks that this is normal, well, you gotta do some thinking. Look at these big long lines in the sky. And all that you see up there looks like clouds, but those are not clouds. Those are at about, I would estimate, 75,000 feet. And the jets just lay out these things everywhere. And we'll look over here, now you can't see it yet, I'm going to zoom in. And we can see, oh, let me put my camera down so it's easier to hold here. Here's a jet right here, laying a chemtrail. So let's see if I can hold this steady. It's very, very far away. And look at the size of the chemtrails behind this thing. These chemtrails just go on and on and on forever. That is not condensation. Condensation is water vapor. Water vapor is created by temperature differences and it always disappears. So you can see one chemtrail after another being laid out. And there's a look at a chemtrail sky. All that you see up there is the results of chemtrailing. That is not natural clouds. And I'm gonna have to keep this video going, hopefully by the time this jet gets a little closer, because I want to show you something about the altitude of these artificial clouds that are up in the sky. And how I'm going to show you this is that when that jet comes closer, I want you to see that the jet is flying at a very high altitude. That is why the jet is so small in the viewfinder. And it's so small that I can't even see it on the screen here, but I know it's there, so I'm gonna zoom in. Where is it? I think it's right there. No, it's not there. I will find it. There it goes through the cloud. And it is right there. So if I zoom in here, we should see it. There it is. So this airplane is flying at a really, really high altitude. That is why it's so small. And I estimate it's flying at least 50,000 feet. So I'm gonna try to get a focus on it. Oops, I lost it again. It's so small in the screen. There it is. And what I want you to see, if we look back here, you can see that the chemtrail that jet is laying is much lower altitude than those other clouds that appear to be real clouds, but they're not. Those other clouds up there are like, if that plane's at 50,000 feet, those clouds up there must be at 100,000 feet or even higher. So when they lay out these chemtrails, they go up in the sky, they go up higher, I suppose, because regular clouds, storm clouds and everything else, I don't believe they ever go over 30,000 feet. And this plane is moving really, really fast. But as it approaches, I'm going to try to get a clearer bead on it so you can see it. Come on, camera. There we go. Nope, still not focusing. Sometimes these cameras, they don't like me trying to focus on things that aren't clear, because these autofocus cameras. Okay, so now you're going to see the airplane is really tiny, so you know it's got to be at least 50,000 feet, but it's well below the clouds above it. And the reason why airplanes fly at really high altitude is because the air is thinner. And where the air is thinner, it makes it cheaper to fly an airplane. And it can fly faster. So I'm doing pretty good here trying to keep this in my camera so you can have a look at it. And this is so hard to do because you think it's easy, but I have to hold this camera so, so steady. It's like trying to hold a pair of binoculars. I lost it again. So it's going to be hard to find because it's flying underneath the other clouds and the camera can't really see it. Okay, so there's the line. Let's see if I can find it. It's going to go beyond my view very soon. No, I might have lost it already. So anyway, you've got an idea now what is going on. The chemtrails that the jets are laying are at least 50,000 feet, and the stuff up in the sky is way up on the edge of space, and it's not, those are not rain clouds. Rain clouds don't go up that high, they're too heavy. And so people think that the stuff that they see up there is from condensation or from moisture, but it's not. What they're spraying up there is a ultra fine powder, which is made out of aluminum and barium, which is part of their Star Wars program and their HARP program, so that they can bounce their signals, their frequency signals, all over the world, anywhere they want, off the shield that they're putting up there. It's basically like a television screen, or not a short, should say a screen in a movie theater. But the chemtrailing hasn't stopped, and it's been going on, what, for at least 20 years now. And I'll tell you, I look out my window every day and I see the stuff in the sky, and there's no more deep blue skies. All we've got in at the very most, when there's no clouds up there at all, it's almost white, the sky, because the sun has a tendency to light up these really fine particles. And people wonder why it is that most nights, if there's no clouds, you can see the stars. It's because there's no light from the sun to light up these really fine particles. It's not that they're not there or they're disappearing, it's just that they're really hard to see. If airplanes are chemtrailing at nighttime, that can be seen usually in a camera. And I'm going to show you the whisperer type effect that these clouds have, because they're not clouds. But if you look at this one, it's all like circular, you know. Normal clouds would be random and puffy and all, you know, do all kinds of different things. When I was young, I studied cloud formations because I was curious about it. And I knew all the different names and types of clouds and their altitudes. And these things here, that what you're looking at, these aren't even clouds. This is all chemtrail residue, which just accumulates and accumulates in the atmosphere. And anyway, the military is behind this, and they're just going to keep doing it, and they're driving me crazy and everybody else who knows anything about this, and go, why on earth are they spraying our planet like this? You know, because, you know, this is crazy. Halifax, where I live, is like 1,000 miles from the nearest big city. And our airport's like 80 miles out of town, and we're lucky if we get three commercial aircraft that leave this Halifax airport a day. Halifax is not a big town. And so we're not over any jet streams. We're not over any paths for airplanes. And when you see these planes, okay, like there's another one over here coming. So it's like going out fishing. You wait and you see another one. So here's another one coming right here. Let's see if I can spot it somewhere in here. There we go. There it is. As you can see, these things are at such high altitude. And I'm going to see if my camera can focus on it. It's hard. Right now we're at a 35 times zoom, but the camera can't focus because it can't. It's just so small. So I'm going to back up and come back and try again. Here we go. Let's do it faster. See if it keeps its focus. There we go. It's keeping its focus. Yeah. Nope. Lost the focus again. So we have another jet right there flying at... I hate to tell you, but I mean, it's probably even higher than 50,000 feet. That jet is so tiny. But you can see in the pictures that the chemtrails it's laying are below those clouds that are up there in the sky, which are bordering on space. And those clouds are not real clouds. So I'm going to turn off the camera now, because you've got an idea how these chemtrail things up there, people think they're clouds and they're not. And especially the young people. The young people don't know what the skies are supposed to look like. I see another jet right here, so before I put my camera away, I'm going to try to capture this one really up close, because it's pretty close to me and I can see it. So let's see if we can get a clear shot of this one. So right now we're at 116 zoom, 140, there you go, 140 times zoom. And that's really hard to hold the camera. Oh, we lost it. So again, I'm going to back up and you can get an idea just how far away this is. See how far that is? That is really far. So I hope you enjoyed this and a little peek at the sunset here over Halifax. Every day now we have colored sunsets, and the color goes all the way across the horizon because of the materials that they've laid in the atmosphere are giving us colors every single night, every morning and every night. And people think that's normal, but the reason why there's so much color on the horizon is because when you're looking up here, the chemtrail material is thinner, and the more you go down towards the horizon, the thicker it gets because of the way the Earth goes around in a circle. So what you're looking at here, when you see the colors, is you're looking through a much denser thickness of chemtrail material. So if you think that the sunsets where there's color in the sky is natural every single night now, it's not natural. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this lesson in chemtrails.